to have a fulfilling life and career, understand yourself, manage yourself, and understand other people. Many talented people do not reach their potential because they confuse two and three, and they try too hard to manage other people and don't manage themselves enough. You have to understand first that your thoughts are not always correct, and the thoughts that go through your mind are not the only truth out there. That's one thing you really need to understand when it comes to managing yourself. The second thing you need to understand is that by changing the manner in which you observe things, you can change your thoughts. And third, if you understand why it is that certain thoughts surface, then you at least have the door open for being able to reprogram yourself. Those are the core principles of being able to manage yourself. Okay, now let's take just the first one, which is just because a thought enters your mind doesn't mean that it is factually correct. There are people, I'll tell you, that live their entire life with the assumption that every thought that enters in their mind is factually correct. It has to be factually correct. So they can't even take that first step. How does this manifest? Oh yeah, this person's just an idiot. Or this person is out to get me. Or this person just doesn't understand me. Or our CEO has no idea what is going on and they don't know what they're doing. This other person is too political. I am a martyr. I'm the only one who cares around here, etc., etc. People get these thoughts all the time. And most people, the thought comes, and they say, aha, the thought is here. And now they start acting as though that thought is correct. Until you understand that every thought that enters your mind doesn't have to be factually correct, there is no progress to be made. Some people, they naturally understand this. Since early childhood, they understand this. It's not some growth mindset thing or like, oh, I worked hard. No, you get zero credit for being that person. You were just wired that way. Just like you don't get to criticize necessarily the person who just believes every thought that enters. That's how people are wired. And yes, upbringing can change things a little bit. For the most part, we're just wired a certain way. But again, we can change these patterns. Maybe the thought is, oh, our priorities are bullshit. They're the wrong priorities, right? Okay, the thought came. It's like, oh, is there a possibility that I'm incorrect about it? Is there a possibility that I'm missing something? Is there a possibility that somebody else knows more about this than I do? That's why this is such a big breakthrough, because it kind of opens up the door for you to be able to do this exploration. So now you are able to augment your thought processes better. And then you're able to put it in action, which is like, oh, instead of just going to that team and telling them, you guys are not fulfilling the contract that we had established and you guys haven't delivered this and that thing. And it seems like there isn't any interest in achieving this milestone. Instead of any of that kind of outburst, I'm going to approach the situation with more curiosity. And that's how this links to managing and understanding other people. Because if I go with that attitude of, well, it seems to me there is some misalignment of priorities, but I want to understand your point of view. Like, what is getting in the way of us being able to reach this milestone? Is there something we can do to address it? How do we problem solve together, right? That way of approaching things is a more productive way of doing it, rather than, oh, well, the thought came and the thought is correct, and now I'm going to figure out how to resolve the thought.